All right. Happy Wednesday, everyone. Mike Brenhog here with Lead Squeezers. And today what I'm going to share with you are seven reasons why your business must be on social media. All right. So there's, you know, a lot of noise about social media and you think that, wow, you know, I'd like to be on social media, but I need to be a top influencer. You do not need to be a top influencer to get traction and to get engagement and conversion from social media. So don't believe that for a second, but I'm going to share with you seven reasons why social media is necessary for you to grow your business. And then I'm going to share with you some statistics about social media. Let's face it, it's not going away. All right. You know, back in the day when the IBM ATs and XTs back in the, you know, early to mid 80s, Bill Gates, his big audacious goal was to have his software in every home, right? On every computer. Well, it has exceeded that. Now homes have multiple computers, plus we have these mobile phones, plus we have our smart cars. I mean, all these tablets and devices and Kindles and Apples. I mean, it's unbelievable. There are so many devices that utilize social media. Now, in addition is television. You know, that box that you used to watch that you have to stand up to turn the channel on the TV. Well, guess what? You can access social media through your television now. Can you believe that? So there's so many reasons why you need to be on social media. But let me jump into this right here because this is super important. All right. First of all, here are the seven reasons. I'm going to go through this quickly and then I'm going to share with you where you can find some additional details and read one of our recent blogs that we just did on this as well. So let me talk to you about this. So here are the seven reasons why you need to be on social media. Number one is exposure. You need to increase your exposure. You know, if you're selling a product or a service and you are not on social media, or if you have a very limited marketing and sales channels, you're limiting your exposure and you're going to limit your opportunities. So the number one reason that you need to be on social media is simply to increase your exposure. Imagine being the head of a major brand and your responsibility was to get your product or your service out on a very large scale. And if all you did was limit it to dialing, you would be limiting yourself and your opportunities. You wouldn't do that. You would get fired. Honestly, you'd get fired. All right. The board of directors like, what are you doing? You're not doing everything you can. So the question is, are you doing everything you can to maximize your exposure? Well, that's why you need to be on social media, all right? Number two, validation. It allows your prospects, your customers, your contacts in your market to validate you. If they can't find you, then you must not be legit. All right. So if you want to be found, you want them to validate you so they can feel comfortable with you, you need to be on social media. All right. Number three, improves the SEO, the search engine results. See what happens when somebody types in that Google and they begin a search for you or a product or service that you're offering, and the search engines go out there and they try and grab all the relevant information to display it to that person that searched. And if you can't be found, and if you're not on social media, you're not going to be displayed, all right? It's just simply not going to happen. But more importantly, if they Google you specifically because they want to check you out, and if they can't find you, then what's going to display? Well, here's what will happen. Let's say somebody is Googling you and your final expense product or service, and they can't find you. Google or the search engines, they will display the most relevant information that it can find. And good chances are, if you're not on social media and they can't find you, it's going to display your competition. Now, think about that. You can't be found. and Google and the search engines are showing your competition, you're limiting your opportunities. All right. Number four, educate your market. Use the social media platform to educate your market on the value and of your products and services. It's a great opportunity in short little nuggets. You can do a static post or video post, but you're educating them on the value of your products and services. What separates you from all your competition out there? What is that? Use the platform to educate your market, all right? Number five, shareability. Now, think about that. Are you making it easy for your market, your prospects, your customers, those people that you know to share you? Most people are not easily shareable. So how can you expect to get any referral business if people can't find you and they can't easily share you? See, there's this thing on the social media, on all of them, they have that little share button down there. Boom, click, you can share that. You can share it to a group. You can share it in a direct message, but it makes it easy for people to find you and to share you. So make it easy for people if you want more business. Number six, trust and credibility. Now, this is huge. People like to do business with people they know, like, and trust. But if they can't get to know you, then how are they going to know you, like you, and trust you, right? It's just not going to happen. It blows me away that so many sales professionals out there simply do not have a good social media presence. So they never have an opportunity to get to know you, your products, your services, and your company. And therefore, the person that does a great job at that, your competition possibly, is going to win the business because they're the people that are your customers and your prospects know, like, and trust. All right. So when you have a consistent schedule and you're posting regularly to social media, that will definitely build your trust and credibility. You're becoming more familiar. All right. Now, number seven, simply put, top of mind. If you are not top of mind with your market, your prospects, and your customers, then your competition is. Someone is. They're consumers. And when they are looking for a product or service, they are going to go out to the internet. We're dealing with what we call a much more educated consumer because we have this great tool called the internet that allows them to do research. And they're doing the research from their laptop, from their tablet, from their desktop, but most of them are doing it right here from their mobile phone, their smartphone, right? And so if they can't find you and if you're not top of mind, when they're thinking about your product or your service that you offer, who are they thinking of? They're thinking of your competition, all right? So these are seven reasons why you absolutely must be on social media and you do not need to be a top influencer to benefit from social media, all right? So wanted to share that with you. So the reason that you're not on social media, let me share with you why people are not. One, it takes time. It takes time to come up with content, to create an image, to write a short little message, or to create a video. It takes time to be on social media. Therefore, many people are like, I'm not going to do it. Or they may try it for a week or two and, you know, they just can't get any regular consistent schedule with it. Because you're busy, right? You're busy out there drumming up business. And the reason that it becomes a challenge is social media oftentimes is not an immediate gratification. It takes time, consistent posting to build more of a following where people are seeing you, they're seeing your message. So because it's not immediate gratification and it takes time, most sales professionals, if they don't see results within the first 2 weeks, they give up. And that is why they're not on social media. So for those of you that realize the value in social media and you can be consistent, you are going to be light years ahead of your competition because it's not going away. I promise you, if you think that computers and social media are going away, you're fooling yourself. It's just not going to happen, right? And so you need to have a strong presence for all these reasons I mentioned here. Now, with Lead Squeezers, one of the things that we do is we understand that sales professionals are busy. They have a lot going on. So all of the tools that we have, and let me share with you real quick. By the way, here's our website here. And if you want to read this in detail, this blog, you can go to leadsqueezers.com, go to the blogs that's right up here under marketing services, and it will take you right to this blog here. But one of the things that I wanted to share with you is we're all about marketing tools to help you squeeze more business. So we have a social media platform. We have content that we have already created that you don't have to create. And we will schedule that content to post to your social media consistently multiple times a week so that you can have a presence out there and you can start building a following with that. And it's to most of the platforms that we can post to, okay, on your behalf. Now, you want to supplement that with some of your own posts as well, but at least it's going to get you started. So you can check more out by visiting the social media page here on our leadsqueezers.com. Just click on social media and you'll find it there. More details here and you can sign up for that. Or if you're already a Lead Squeezers, many of our plans that we offer already include it, all right? And you can also, you'll see a sampling of some of our social media posts. We have a great variety of posts for many different markets, all right? So you have that there. Let me move this out of the way. And since we're talking about social media, what I wanna do is I wanna share some statistics with you and some demographics. And I'm just going to go through this real quick here, okay, and to share with you. So let's take a look here. Now, when you look at the social media platforms, this will give you an idea of the size of audience that each platform has. Let's take a look here, with Facebook being the largest, 2.91 billion with a B, okay? Twitter, 353 million. Instagram, 2 billion, LinkedIn, 800 million, Pinterest, 444 million, and TikTok, one of the newer ones, 1 billion, all right? And there's other platforms out there like Snapchat as well. But for today's purpose, the demographics, I'm going to share with you some statistics and demographics for Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn, all right? These are the three primary that most people need to be on. TikTok is coming up fast as well. So that's another great platform. But let's take a look at these statistics here for Facebook. Now, 2.91 billion monthly active users. All right. 81% of adults in the US have a Facebook account. Think about that. So again, this is why you need to be on social media. You want to have access to your market. Facebook also has great filtering options. If you're going to run some Facebook ads, you can target, you know, based on age, local demographics, likes and interests that they have. So it's just a great marketing platform to tap into new markets and to create either a new following or a new customer base. All right. Now, I'm not going to read through each one of these. I just want to hit on some of the highlights. All right. Between the ages of 25 and 34, 12.5% of active Facebook users are female and 19% are female. All right. And so you're going to see a lot of women and in certain platforms versus, you know, male users. Facebook, you know, more of the male. With 11.2 billion total visits, 1.5 billion unique visitors. So what does that mean? Well, it means that people are going to Facebook multiple times. So 1.5 billion unique visitors and an average visit of 21 minutes, all right, per day. Average of 21 minutes, all right? Check that out. That is huge. All right. 75% of high income earners use Facebook. So when it comes to marketing, people ask me, Mike, you know, I want to reach, for example, and I'll use a comparison of LinkedIn to Facebook and Instagram. All right. And here's the deal. Let's set aside statistics for a moment and let's just look at regular user behavior. Let's say you are trying to reach a business owner or somebody that is more affluent, and if they're, then they could have a LinkedIn profile if they're a business owner, most likely they do. But think about your own social media behavior as well. How often are you on LinkedIn? All right, because I have a lot of people, well, I just want to focus on LinkedIn, Mike, because that's where business owners are. I get it. They have a profile, they have an account, but how often are they on LinkedIn? All right, think about that. How often are you on LinkedIn? How often? See, they may have an account, but they're not on LinkedIn that often. Now, let's take a look at Facebook. Facebook tells us right here, 21 minutes on average. And why are they on Facebook? Because that's where their family is. That's where their family is posting pictures of, you know, throughout their day, where they're going to dinner, where they're vacationing. They want to see their grandkids. They want to see their children. That's where their family is at. It's not always about business. See, LinkedIn is more about business. Their family's not on LinkedIn, okay? This is why Facebook is so powerful. Instagram the same way, right? You're finding more and more people on Instagram now. Families are there. More of my family is posting there, all right? And they're posting great content, and you want to be connected with your family, so you go there. So that's why Facebook and Instagram are great platforms to become familiar, to increase your exposure, because that's where people are hanging out, basically, right? So it's extremely powerful. Let's take a look at this. Facebook is the world's third most downloaded app. Wow. The average US adult spends 33 minutes a day on Facebook. That is incredible. All right. Again, I'm not going to touch on all these. I'll leave it up for a second so you can kind of check these out. But I want to make sure we get through all these points here. Over 1.8 billion people now use Facebook groups every month. That is huge. There's a lot of groups. Facebook is a great platform for connecting people, bringing people that are like-minded with similar interests together where they can collaborate and they can share. It's really powerful. You may not like Mark Zuckerberg. You don't have to, right? You may not like some of the things that they're about, but you can't deny the fact it's a great marketing platform. And if you're in business, you need to be on social media. You need to capitalize on this and take advantage of it, all right? It's phenomenal. All right, so let's take a look at this. Facebook engagement stats, all right? It's people that are actually engaging. More than 4 billion video views take place on Facebook every day. Videos are becoming huge. You know, people sitting there on their phone, literally scrolling through. And now with video activity, it's much more appealing, right? Entertaining. See, what's interesting about social media, it has become a platform for entertainment, education, and news. And oftentimes you're getting all three together. You're being entertained, you're educated, and you're getting some news, right? So it's extremely powerful in short nuggets. Also, you know, so we have become programmed in social media is creating, you know, people to have ADD basically because our attention span is so short because we're just flipping through. And TikTok is the same way, Instagram the same way, right? You're just flipping through. You're looking for little nuggets to be entertained, educating, and capture some news. But 4 billion video views, that is absolutely huge. Check this out. 85% of smartphone users have a Facebook app. Wow, that is incredible. Absolutely incredible. All right, let's look at business stats. There are more than 200 million businesses on Facebook. Yeah, I think it's probably even a little more than that now. 44% of users admit that Facebook influences their shopping decision. Why is that? Because they see ads, right? Have you ever noticed, and it can be pretty scary, that someone or you might be shopping for a new pair of tennis shoes, right? And then those exact same shoes, and you leave that website, you never buy them, and then you go on Facebook or you go to another website, and that exact same shoe that you were shopping for shows up, and you're like, how did they know, right? It's because the internet, they are tracking. It's called cookies, all right? They are tracking everything. They're following you, and Facebook is notorious, you know, for that. All the platforms, you're going to see ads, especially if you're on another website, and they utilize, you know, retargeting as well. So, but it's pretty amazing. That's why you need to be on social media. All right. There are over 80 million business Facebook, business pages on Facebook. So you can have a personal account, but for your business, what we recommend is establishing a business page, right? So you can keep them separate. You can have your business message that you're posting regularly and a business audience that is separate from your personal friends and family, right? 15% of Facebook users shop on Facebook. 93% of all social media marketers use Facebook ads. It is super, super powerful. Facebook ad revenue is $28.2 billion in Q3 of 2021. So obviously, probably a little more than that. But anyways, great statistics. 84% of video marketers use Facebook to promote their videos. Yeah, it's another great platform. So even if you're on YouTube and some of these other platforms, many of them will take that video and they will repost it on Facebook, Instagram, and other platforms to drive more traffic. What are they doing? They're increasing their exposure. That's what it's about, all right? 96% of B2C, that's business to consumers, marketers, and 91% of B2B, which is your business to business marketers, use Facebook. So pretty interesting. Let's see if there's anything here. There's a ton of stats, and I want to get to some of those other platforms here. Let's take a look here. Let's shift over to Instagram here, share some stats with you. Right. Take a look at this. Instagram demographic stats. Now, it's important to know your audience and who you're targeting, because each platform will have different demographics, meaning different age, right? And so what you're going to see on Instagram is you're going to see a younger crowd. 64% of Instagrammers are under age 34. 64%. All right. I think this number is probably increased because this data is about a little over a year old, but the 25 to 35 year old age group is the largest of the demographics, attributing to 31.2% of the total Instagram population. So if you want to target those younger folks in that age range, boy, Instagram's where it's at. That's where you want to be. Daily active users on Instagram stories are 500 million, 17.6 of the world population uses Instagram. Much less than Facebook, right? Instagram, 51.6% female and 48.4% male audience, all right? The highest user of Instagram are in India and the US, following the US, 157 million, and then Brazil. So, you know, the US market for many of us is where we're focused on targeting, all right? So let's take a look at the next one here. 58% of marketers are planning to leverage Reels in 2022. Reels are a video post, not a static post. Again, videos are blowing up. You want to have videos, podcasts, short little nuggets. YouTube has YouTube Shorts, all right? TikTok created an environment of short little videos that are less than a minute. And, you know, people eat that up because they can, again, go through and just scroll through real quick to be entertained, educated, and get their news, all right? 21% of users log in weekly, 38% of users log into the platform multiple times. They're checking it multiple times, you know, a day. More than 100 million photos are uploaded on the platform each day. Think about that. Think about for Facebook and Instagram or any of these large social media platforms, 100 million photos uploaded each day. Think of the monstrous, system that you have to store those photos and to be able to display them. I mean, it's really incredible if you think about it. The average time spent on Instagram is 28 minutes. 70% of the people watch Instagram stories each day. 130 million users tap on shopping posts each month. So pretty powerful. Let's take a look at some other statistics here. The average engagement rate for all post types is 0.83%, so not quite 1%. Business accounts with fewer than 10,000 followers have an average engagement rate of 1.1%. Business accounts with 10,000 to 100,000 followers have an average rate of 0.93%. Now, it's a small difference, but I can tell you that the reason that is when you're a smaller business, you have a much more intimate type following, right? You're probably more engaged, more influencer. As it starts to grow, and if you're a larger following, you have a tendency to get less connected sometimes with your following. And so that's why you're going to have less of an engagement. And your messaging might not be as relevant as your audience grows, right? Whereas when you're starting out, you have a really tight message. You're really connecting with folks. The average number of likes per Instagram post is 1,261. Let's see here. 100 million Instagrammers watch or launch live videos daily. I mean, this is powerful. So I'm sharing all this with you to give you a sense of the demographics and the stats for social media, supporting why you need to be on social media. It's a huge ass audience and you need to be there. Let's take a look at some Instagram ad insights. 50% of Instagram users are more interested in a brand when they see ads on Instagram. This comes back to a couple of things that I pointed out on the 7 reasons why. One, people like to do business with people and companies they know, like, and trust. So when a brand is on social media and there's an ad, they become more familiar, they become more trusted, they become more known, right? Which is why Instagram marketers spend 69% of their budget on influencer marketing on Instagram. Let's see what else we have. 1.3 billion people can be reached through advertisements on Instagram. This is huge. 48.4% is female, 51.6% is male. All right. So, and video ads have 3 times more engagement than photos. 3 times. So that's just huge. And you can do a mix, right? There's nothing wrong with a mix, because posting videos and creating videos is a little more time consuming than creating a static post. All right. So create a variety. But all right, let's take a look at LinkedIn. All right, LinkedIn statistics. Now with LinkedIn, this is designed more for the business, the B2B, all right? The population of LinkedIn is more than 800 million from 200 countries. There are 180 million users from the US on LinkedIn, all right? There are 56.6 male, 43.4% female. India is huge, obviously. China, Brazil. Let me come back here. Sorry about that. So you can see these other markets, but we're focused mostly for most of us on the US market, which is the largest market for LinkedIn. All right. There are 180 million senior level influencers. And these are the people that, when you think about the business community that you want to reach, they're going to have more money. They're more of a leader. They're a decision maker, right? This is where the money's at typically, but it can be difficult to reach these people even on LinkedIn, if your message isn't powerful, if it's not compelling to grab their attention. That's why trying to have a platform or reach them on another platform like Instagram or Facebook through other connections can be powerful, because that's where they're at. Their family is on those other platforms. Their family is not on LinkedIn. All right. They're not seeing their grandkids on LinkedIn. LinkedIn has 65 million decision makers and 10 million C-level executives. Almost 60% of LinkedIn users are in the age group 25 to 34. And the reason is because they're looking for jobs and career. They're in that career mode. They're building their career. And it's all about connection. It's all about who you know. So if you're looking at building your career and your business, you are looking at serving and trying to tap into this 25 to 34 year old market that are building their career. There's a lot of changes happening. And if your product or services for that market, then this is a great platform. All right. 60% of the US LinkedIn users earn $100,000 a year, 60%. So there you go. That's a pretty good number to know. All right. If you're trying to reach, you know, those folks, let's take a look at some usage stats. Three professionals join LinkedIn every second. 50% of LinkedIn traffic comes from mobile devices. You can see mobile. Everything that you're doing now, your website, everything that you do needs to be mobile friendly because people are accessing everything from their mobile device. All right. Three people get hired on LinkedIn every minute. 91% of executives rate LinkedIn as their first choice for professionally relevant content. And that's a good way to put it right there. LinkedIn is a great place for professional relevant contact and to connect with your peers and your colleagues within the industry. All right. 280 billion feed updates are viewed annually. There are 9 billion content impressions in LinkedIn feeds every week. 2 million posts, articles, and videos are published on LinkedIn every day. That is small compared to the 100 million on Instagram that are posted every day. All right. 3 million users post on LinkedIn every week, not day, every week. So not as much activity. It's because not as many people are visiting LinkedIn on a regular basis, okay, or checking their messages. Some other usage stats, 45% of LinkedIn readers are upper level positions. All right. On average, users spend 7 minutes. That's quite a bit less than the 22 or the 33 minutes from Facebook and Instagram. All right. The average visit duration on LinkedIn is 8.52 minutes. Users visit an average 6.4 pages on LinkedIn before leaving. So you can see the engagement is less also. One, they're not visiting as frequently. They're not spending as much time and the engagement is less. But again, depending on your product and service, this is a great social media platform to reach your future customers, right? So you need to know your market. Comes back to a couple things. One, knowing your ideal client and finding out where they spend their time and having a presence there. The other is expanding your exposure, all right? You never want to limit yourself. I always suggest that if you don't have a multi-channel sales and marketing approach, you are limiting your opportunities. Never rely on just, you know, one channel or one lead source. It will cause you to go broke, literally. So 39% of users are LinkedIn premium account holders, all right? And I can tell you, well, the stat that I would like to see, I bet you many of those are recruiters, all right? Okay, 22% of LinkedIn traffic comes from a search alone, so that's lower. 99.63% of LinkedIn traffic comes from organic searches, all right? Each week, 45 million people look for a job on LinkedIn. So if you're, again, trying to find job seekers, this could be a great place. Let's see. There's a 50% rise in engagement. That's great. Companies post weekly, see an engagement rise by 2 times. So not quite as strong as, again, Facebook and Instagram. But that shares, you know, some good stats. Let's take a look at some business stats real quick here. Including the links in a post can drive twice the engagement than a post without LinkedIn. All right. Again, if you have a post, a blog, you don't want to post it just to one platform. Post it to multiple platforms. Post it to your website. maximize your exposure. You've gone through the effort of either creating a video or writing a blog. Don't limit it to just one channel. Maximize it all you can. Again, if you are the head of a major brand, you're going to do everything you can to make sure you maximize the exposure. Just because you're an independent sales professional or a small business owner doesn't necessarily mean that you need to limit your opportunities, all right? So what else do we have? More than 57 million companies are listed on LinkedIn. 46% of social media traffic to the company's website comes from LinkedIn. Interesting. So a company, B2B, 46% of the social media traffic comes from LinkedIn. That is interesting. 45% of marketers have gained customers through LinkedIn. Lead gen forms on LinkedIn can increase conversion. That's a form on LinkedIn. So it's a paid ad, basically. And when somebody sees your post or sees your ad, they're going to fill out a form on LinkedIn. And because it's a trusted source, can increase conversion by 3 times. All right. 89% of B2B marketers rely on LinkedIn for lead generation. Now, I have found that from our experience and running ads on social media, that for the consumer market, and a lot of folks try to do it, they want to tap into it. But for the B2C, LinkedIn just isn't. It's great for B2B. But if you're selling, for example, final expense life insurance, LinkedIn is not the platform to be on. You want to be on Facebook, where 89.1% of U.S. adults have a Facebook account. And, you know, a few years ago, people said, oh, you know, the senior market, they're not on Facebook. Well, they're, trust me, they're on Facebook. They are there. And the reason they're there is because they want to see their children and their grandchildren. All right. It's a great way to share photos and moments, Kodak moments. Remember Kodak, those Kodak moments? It's a great way to share Kodak moments on Facebook with grandma and grandpa. All right. So that's why we're there. All right. So there we go. All right. 7 reasons why you must be on social media to increase your exposure and to grow your business. And so that's all I have to share with you today. I hope you find this valuable, but more importantly, what I want to share is that you need to be on social media. And if you need assistance, come here right here to leadsqueezers.com. We can help you. Go to our social media page right here. Learn a little more about our social media services here. Again, we create the content, we post to multiple platforms each week on your behalf so that you can start being consistent on social media and then posting your content on top of it to even get greater traction, all right? So anyways, you can check this out. Again, leadsqueezers.com. Go to our social media page and you can always reach out to us online through chat. Or on social media. We'll be happy to get you set up so you can increase your exposure and grow your business. So anyways, hope you guys have an awesome day. Take care.